Hi everyone, this is Mr. West. We are doing a Khan Academy tutorial today on finding the surface area by adding area of faces. That's by definition the how to find surface area is adding all the different surfaces, which are the sum of the different sides of the 3D shape. So here we have which expression can be used to find the surface area of the following rectangular prism. Essentially what we're doing here is we are taking the surface, each surface, so there's a green one right there that's showing that top little rectangle. Then we have this side, okay, if you're thinking about just like the best way to think of surface area is a cardboard box and you have the different sides and when you fold it out, you can see the different shapes real clearly. Now that's three, there's three more on the back and on the bottom that you can see, like just as an example, there's that green one that matches the top one and then this blue one on the side matches that side one also, okay? So I'm gonna undo that just to give a little bit better perspective. But that's essentially what we're doing. We're finding the area of those three rectangles, doubling them, and then adding them all together. I think it's always best to start by drawing each one separately. So we have our green top one, we have our front one, and then we have our side one, okay? The side one is the most clear. We have a 5x2. Right, now we're moving on to the red one. We see that the bottom is 3. We don't have the measurement for the side. We can find that easy enough. That's also 5 because that is the height of this particular prism. Next, we have the top, and we know that this side component right here is going to be the same as this side right here. That's 2, so that is also going to be 2. And then this length or width or however you want to call it, I like to call it this width, the 2, the depth, because it gives perspective, 3D perspective depth. So this is going to be 3 right there. Now we can easily find the area of these rectangles because we know the area of the rectangle is length times width. So we just need to multiply these dimensions together. So the area is going to be 3 times 2, 5 times 3, and then area equals 5 times 2. That's going to be equal to 15, equal to 6, equal to 10. Now here's the deal. That's only one of the faces. Remember, it's a rectangular prism, so it has 6 faces. That means we need to multiply this times 2, this times 2, and this times 2. Because like I said before, it's also on the side, it's also on the bottom, and it's also in the back. Okay, so there's 2 sides with that same dimension. So we're looking for 6 plus 6 plus 15 plus 15 plus 2, 10 plus 10, all right? And that's this first one. See how it has the sum of the faces there? And that's it. We're good to go. Here's our answer. All right, next question. Ooh, here we have a pyramid. Which expression can be used to find the surface area of the following square pyramid? Okay, pyramids are a little bit more tricky, but not that bad. We have a square pyramid, okay? It's a big clue here. It's telling us it's a square pyramid, so we know this is gonna be 2x2. Well, for a square, we just multiply, it's the same as rectangle, that's gonna be area 4. But notice how there's only one square. Now we're moving on to its other component shape, which is a triangle, okay? So here's our triangle, here's one of them at least, and I'm drawing it here. Now, it only gives us this height for one of the triangles, but it has to be the same for all of them because it's the same height. Otherwise, they wouldn't all meet up at one exact point like it does for a pyramid. Now, we already know that's a square pyramid, so these bases are all going to be 2. So essentially what we have going on here is we have this triangle. I know yellow is not the best color, but there it is. And then we have the base of 2. So this is one of these triangles, and how many do you suppose we have? Think about it, answer it. Are you ready for the answer? There's 4 of them, okay? So there's 4 of these triangles. Now the area of a triangle is equal to 1/2 base times height, where the base and the height are perpendicular. That's why that 90 degrees is essential for this problem. So we're just simply going to do 3, which is, oops, actually that's our height. So I'll do 2 times, why'd I hit undo? 2 times 3. That's equal to 6 divided by 2, and that's equal to 3. So our area for one of the triangles is 3. So we have to multiply that by 4, or add it 4 times together. So that's 12 plus 4, that would be 16. Or we're gonna look here, and we're gonna look for our appropriate answer. Okay, notice here, this one's trying to trick you if you forgot to multiply it by 1/2. Here's our square bottom, and then here's the four triangles, okay? Area of 3, so it's D is our answer. Moving on to the next question, we have a triangular prism. These are pretty cool. Two different shapes, okay? Kind of like the pyramid, but we have two triangles for the base this time. Okay, two triangles for the base. And then we have three different rectangles. We have this green rectangle, we have this blue bottom rectangle, and then we have this red side rectangle. So I hope you can see those three different shapes. We are gonna decompose them. So here's our first one, okay, 6 by 8. And I didn't write the 10, and why didn't I write the 10? Because we only care about the perpendicular distances. So we're gonna do 1/2, this is our triangle. Base times height, that is equal to 24. Now, there's two of these triangles, so we need to multiply that by 2, okay? So that's our first surface area shape. So we're gonna multiply 24 times 2, which is gonna be 48, but I don't think it's gonna ask us for 48. There's 48, I think it's trying to trick us. I think it's gonna be more like this, 2 24s. Definitely not A. Okay, moving on to the rectangle, we have, make sure you decompose it, which means draw it again. That's the best way to think of it. Notice how it's a 6 by 10 for this red rectangle. Length times width is 6 times 10 for a rectangle, and that is 60. We only have one of these though. We don't multiply this by 2. Notice we only have one red rectangle. Let's move on to the green one. This one's a 20. Oh, I messed up. Look what I did. I messed up. That's not 10 for that distance, it's 20 for that distance. This whole length is 20. I got confused for a second. Notice how I saw those two? This 10 is that distance right there. That is not even a measurement in my rectangle, so that's 6 times 20. Glad I found that, because now that is gonna be 120. Much better there, and I'm not multiplying that by 2. Now I have 20 by 10, okay? That distance of the rectangle is 10. That is a measurement. And that is 200, okay, there's 200. And now I have my last one, the blue one. I have an 8 by 20. So each one of these rectangles has a length of 20, but the width is different for each one. 8 times 20, that's gonna give me 160. 160, 120, 24, 24. It is C as our answer right here. Last one. Oh, the cube. The cube is nice, nice and easy. Okay, because the cube is defined as a shape which has 6 identical sides. Think of a dice, okay? So I would choose different colors, but they're the same area, each face. And how many faces are there? There's 6. So we're gonna have a 6 by 6, and there's 6 of those. So we do 36 times 6. Looks like one, oh, not this one, not A. We're looking for 36. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There we go. When in doubt, choose. Not really though. All right, hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you learned something. If you're looking for more mathematical tutorials, either on Khan Academy, CUDA, you name it, any type of topic, let me know. You can also leave a comment on something you want me to cover. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you next time.